Senior Ride Service on 1-800-424-079 or download your
comments on voice referendum. Investigations into fatal crashes and AFL fans urge to check transport options. It's 1 o'clock. Good afternoon, I'm Emily Minnie. The Prime Minister has shut down calls to delay the voice referendum during a passionate speech at the Gama Festival. Anthony Albanese is using his appearance at the country's largest annual celebration of First Nations culture to drum up support for the advisory body. He won't say what the exact date for the vote will be, but is promising it will be this year.
There will be no delaying or deferring of this referendum. We will not deny the urgency of this moment. We will not kick the can down the road. We will not abandon substance for symbolism or retreat to platitude at the expense of progress.
Police are investigating after two people died in separate crashes on Sydney's roads last night. Elizabeth reports. A 25-year-old woman was killed after the car she was a passenger in crashed into a parked truck in Ingleburn. The 24-year-old male driver has been escorted to Campbelltown Police Station. No charges have been laid yet. Meanwhile, a motorbike rider in his 20s died after colliding with a car in Cherrybrook. The 20-year-old car driver has undergone mandatory testing and has been released from Gargoyle Police Station pending further investigation. Investigators are asking anyone with dashcam footage of either incident to notify police. In Sydney, Ellis Smith, 9 News. Three men have been charged after an alleged attempted armed robbery in Sydney Southwest in May. The 20-year-old and 39-year-old men were arrested following police raids in Greenacre and Kirrawee. A 31-year-old man was arrested at Granville Police Station and will face term in the Mail Court today. AFL fans heading to tonight's Sydney Derby at Olympic Park are being warned to make their travel plans early. Rail repair work being carried out on the T7 Olympic Park, T1 North Shore and T9 Northern lines this weekend. Transport for New South Wales' Jazz Tumbler says replacement buses will be operating.
Bus replacement service is enhanced. We have extra buses every 3 minutes, which will replace the Olympic Park line, and also there will be additional staff on site to help with boarding and also making sure people get to the event on time.
NASA has used its highest power transmitter to get back in contact with its Voyager 2 space probe, which was launched in 1977. Contact was lost last month after the wrong command tilted its antenna away from Earth. And Donald Trump is back campaigning after pleading not guilty to his third indictment. In finance, one Australian dollar is buying 65.80 US debt. The second letter flow hub crash is underway in the Interline Bus Services through the first half. The Wallabies are leading the All-Blacks 14-3. The Broncos have pulled off 19 games to beat.
$169 for the install. thunderstorm. Possible smoke haze into the afternoon. A top of 20 degrees.
I did a fine speed range, but...